Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to a brand new video here today and the finale of season 3 of my team F1 career mode. And this is it guys, it's the final race. Abu Dhabi, of course, we wrapped up the championship a long time ago. This race is for pride, but there's also a record on the line. We'll get into that in a minute, but we could potentially make history here today. First of all guys, I've got to get the plug out of the way. If you missed the last episode at Brazil, then go check it out. I'll leave a link up in the top right hand corner of your screen. And of course, another one of these races where we've been starting from the back of the grid and trying to force our way through the field. So go check that one out if you haven't done so already. It was also the video where it was confirmed Mercedes would no longer be our power unit supplier heading into season 4. So in this episode, guys, we're going to focus on the race alone. The next episode will be the preview of season 4, and we'll address all the changes over the winter because there's a lot to get through. Otherwise, this episode would be like 50 minutes long. So, yeah, hopefully, guys, appreciate that. Nonetheless, if you're going to enjoy today's episode, guys, today's potentially historic episode, then smash the like button. Let's try and hit 1,000 likes for the finale, guys, and subscribe for more daily F1 content, and also subscribe for the brand new start of season 4, which will start later on this week. So, hopefully, guys, don't miss that. But let's get today's episode underway for the final race of the season here in Abu Dhabi. Well, once again, here we are on the laptop, and this time we're actually addressing some admin that we had pending from the last episode, of course, in this kind of, you know, revised format for these final few races where we've been starting from the back of the grid. First of all, we have to renew some sponsorship, in this case for DSB Optics and the 7th sponsor, which I'm more than happy to keep them on board heading into next year. To be fair, cash isn't exactly a big thing for us. You know, you can see in the top of the screen we've got nearly $60 million, so I'm not particularly concerned. We then assign a few more activities because there's quite a big break until Abu Dhabi, and we're going to make sure we get a decent spread, especially also focusing on aerodynamic department and chassis department, because those two are going to be really badly affected in the regulation change. And now the big moment has arrived. We're going to spend pretty much most of our money on upgrades for the facilities, because of course these will be affected by the regulation change. So we are going to make sure we, you know, put all the building blocks in place to be prepared for any possible changes. So we purchase a build time and a quality control on the aerodynamics and a build time upgrade on the chassis, so things will hopefully be a lot more prepared. I could have spent a bit more, but I want to keep that money on side in case we have to spend that on signing a driver, of course, for season 4, and I don't have my cash bonuses for the end of the season. So as you can see, we then skip ahead on the activities tab on the calendar, and we get all of our bonuses. And with that, we're now ready for the final race here in Yas Marina for the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. We then look at the weather forecast, and this weekend, of course, dry as always, as you'd expect, in the middle of the desert. We then look, finally, for the final time, the R&D graph, and of course, no upgrades this weekend. Everyone fully concentrating on the regulation change for season 4. And with that, we move into practice, the final practice session of the year. And in this one, of course, I'm going to focus on mainly race trim, because qualifying isn't important, as we're not going to qualify, of course, here today. And we're going to start from the back of the grid, as we have done for the last couple of races. So as you can see, just making sure we get a good feel for the car, because if we can get into the right window in the daytime settings, then the car will be very competitive once the nighttime eventually falls. So it was all about trying to maximize this part of the weekend, and the car felt great. We were so quick, just like we have been in the last couple of races. It's just a privilege, it really is, to drive this car. I've got to be honest, you know, at this point I just really appreciate driving a car so strong. I've never had such a dominant car in any of my career modes in my lifetime, and it's just brilliant to just drink it in and be fast wherever I go. Off to practice and qualifying, of course, as well, as we skipped it, we look at the acclaim and also the rivalry, and we've got a 1-point lead over Bottas heading into the race, so it's going to go down to the wire, this one, but hopefully we'll secure the bag and try and win that rivalry. We then look at the acclaim. No real changes after qualifying or practice, because we're such a high level now, not much is going to happen. But I thought, you know what, one last thing before we head into the race, I'd show you guys the season overview before the final race. And you can see on screen the race results. Now you guys can pause this and kind of focus on your favorite drivers, but personally I'm going to look at myself, because as you can see, if you count the race wins, we have 13 race wins, which is currently a three-way tie with Michael Schumacher and Sebastian Vettel for most race wins in a season of all time. So what I mean by this is, if I win the race now here at Abu Dhabi, starting from the back of the grid, I would set a new record, a historic record of 14 race wins in a single season. So we've got something to fight for in this race, and I'm very much looking forward to it. We could potentially make history, and that would cap off this season in the best possible way. So you guys know what the target is. It's to try and get a win from the back of the grid one last time here in season three. So let's jump into it. Let's get the race underway, and let's end season three on a high.
So here we are, ready to go racing for one final time this year. Another season of victories, controversies and rivalries lies in our wake. And just one challenge remains here in the United Arab Emirates on a circuit that made its spectacular debut back in 2009. Welcome to the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. The Yas Marina circuit, just over 3.4 miles long with 21 corners and two very long back straights. There are two DRS zones going into the heavy braking zones of both Turn 8 and Turn 11 and offer plenty of potential for overtaking. The circuit comes with its fair share of tricky corners as well, in particular 15, 16 and 17, which will certainly test a driver's braking management. And so, for one final time this season, Anthony Davidson joins me in the commentary box.
Well, the winter break is looming once again. No doubt many of those teams already have their eyes firmly on next season. But there's still work to be done here. Still championship positions to decide, which can make a big difference to the prize money. So no one's going to be taking their foot off the throttle just yet.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Daniel Ricciardo has a clear view ahead from pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Hamilton, Pierre Gasly, and Verstappen, Vettel, Ocon, Albon, and Carlos Sainz, Norris, Perez, Kevin Magnussen, and Kvyat, Russell, De Vries, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Jack Aitken. Latifi, Grosjean, Martinez, and Lance Stroll brings the grid to a close. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Well, guys, here we go. This is it. It's the final race of season three. We start from P21 on the grid. So not entirely in last place, but still on the final row. And just like last year, we're just going to try and see what we can do and have a bit of fun. Like the last couple of races, you know, there is one thing on the table today, and I might have mentioned it at the start of the video, but we are currently sitting on 13 race wins, and we have tied Michael Schumacher's record of 13 wins in a season. If we win today, we would set a brand new record of 14 wins in a single season, which would be historic. So that would be the perfect way to cap off this season, guys. So that's going to be the target. Try and win the race from the back of the grid. And I'm very much looking forward to the challenge. So let's jump into it. First of all, in terms of strategy, we're going to start in the mediums and then go for two soft tire stints. It worked really well for us last year. And we're going to go for that exact same strategy again. We're then going to run just over half a lap of fuel, so 28.5. Just slightly positive because we're going to need the extra fuel to get through the traffic, I feel like. But generally speaking, I feel confident. We've got a good race car, so let's get the race underway and let's see if we can try and make history in the final race of season three. Here we go then, for the final time. The lights are coming on. We've got to try and get those revs optimized. And there we go, lights out. Final race start, and look at that, we breeze off the line. Absolutely brilliant on the mediums there. Into turn one, there's a big lunge from a Haas. Huge dive bomb into the first corner. Not sure who that was, but they've made that work. Through turn two, now turn three. We're side by side here with Jack Aitken in the Alfa Romeo. Now down towards turn four. I'm boxed in here on the outside. Not really much place for me to go. Just going to try and make sure we get the measure of Aitken here. Now into the hairpin. Again, nowhere I can really go. We're going to use the outside line to just try and find a bit of traction. There we go. These two cars actually don't have much of a toe, so I might get the chance to get past both of them here. We know how good my straight line speed is. Here we go. We're coming through like a steam train to the outside. Got a warning for track limits there, but I had no more space. I wasn't given any room, so I had to use the outside of the track. We're through, though, up to P17. Beautiful double overtake, just using the straight line speed of my car to my advantage. We already know how quick I am on the straights. Look at this. We're breezing up to the back of Russell here. Thought about going down the inside, but we'll just be patient. Try and pick up a move. It looks like it was Grosjean, the Haas, who put that huge dive bomb into the first corner. There's a bit of side by side here. These guys are going very slowly. I want to try and get past if I can soon. Russell again having a good start in the race and running pretty high up, so he's really impressing lately. Driving really well in the Williams. This is so slow. Oh my goodness me, I'm so much quicker than this. Got a racing point in the McLaren going side by side up ahead. Ricciardo already across the start finish. Oh my god, this is so slow. Just got to wait, sit behind, because this is too risky for any kind of move at this point through those corners and the AI. Here we go then, let's see if we can make some moves now. Onto lap two. Just trying to find a bit of space here. Should be able to go flat through here. Just about, slight lift. Back end getting a bit light on me here. Down the inside of Russell. We're going to get that place. Bit of a squeeze into the apex there. My bad. Probably tending a bit too much on him, but we're through nonetheless. Now we've got to get past Grosjean here. We know the Ferraris have lost a lot of straight on speed since the patch. So this should be easy pickings for us. Look at this. There we go. Pulling alongside. And now we're in front. Job done. Another place picked up. Being cautious on the brakes. We might be able to get Kvyat here as well if I can nail this exit through here. Which we do. Absolutely spot on there. And now we're going to race past the AlphaTauri as well. To be fair, the Hondas have been pretty good on the straights, it has to be said. I've been very impressed. The Red Bull and AlphaTauris do hold, actually, quite a good straight line speed. So, respect them. But we're through again on Kvyat. And we're now up to P14. Kevin Magnussen up next on medium tyres. Let's go get him. We're going to try and get this move done nice and quickly. Maybe even get Norris as well, possibly, in the McLaren. Through the hairpin. Going to open up the line. Mercedes engine versus Mercedes engine. And DRS is now enabled, so that's going to make things a little bit trickier, but we should still have the edge. Here we go, we're pulling in on the racing point of Magnussen. He's pulled out the toe, which gives me a bit more of a benefit. Going to go very deep on the brakes, so the long way round there. Inside line through the right, and we are through. Job done, another textbook overtake here. Up to P13 now, unlucky for some. I'm so much quicker than Lando Norris here, I'm just all over the back of him. New personal best, nearly 2 seconds quicker than that. That's more like it. Let's line up. Last lap Lando, Mr. Scenario 7 for a move here. Just going to take my time. We'll try and get him onto the back straight as we get a bit of oversteer there. I get a second warning for track limits. Interesting. Fair enough. Abu Dhabi feeling a bit, you know, strict on track limits, it seems like today. Right, let's get Lando. Getting that line through the hairpin, absolutely perfect. Traction down, overtake engaged, nice and early. And now we just use the straight line speed of our car to make this move. You can see the difference compared to the Mercedes engine of Magnussen. We've got a bit more of an advantage over the Renault. To the outside again. Lando tries to hang on, but we're through. And now P12 is ours. Up next, Perez. I believe he's the last of the medium tyre runners. So let's go get him. Oh, I'm getting very, very close to Perez there. Almost ran into the back of him. Just so much more pace in this car. It's unbelievable. I'm going to really miss driving this car next season. Whatever happens, this is, in terms of balance, this is one of the best fully maxed out cars almost I've ever driven. All right, let's see if we can get Perez then. Through the hairpin. Perfect on the gears there. Getting that rotation, as you saw. And we're now right on the back of him here. We're going to make this move. Here we go. Outside line again. Can we get a slight toe from Ocon up ahead? Looks like we will. Pretty close though. Again, exact same move as the last two laps. Carbon copy through the outside. And we're now P11 and the first of the medium tyre runners. Of those who started outside the top 10, I'm not sure if there's any medium guys out front, you know, Ricciardo or the Mercedes, but up next, soft tyre runners. First off, Esteban Ocon, who's putting some pressure on Carlos Sainz here. Right, let's get Esteban then. And we might actually be able to get Sainz this time. This could be the 2-for-1 special. I'm going to try lining up and see if it happens. Not our best run through the hairpin that time. Didn't quite get the rotation with the gears. But we should still get the run on Ocon here. Or will we? Actually, that Renault is hanging on all right this time. Yeah, not quite close enough. We're going to have to let that one go. And we're going to set up the switchback though through here. Oh, well, there we go. That's better. Much better. We might get the double toe here. This could work out for us quite nicely. Look at this. We're closing in on Carlos here. Three wide. We're going to go down the inside. It's all very tight. We're all locked on. I'm going to have to be careful through here. Oh, my goodness me. And the racing point's coming back through. Oh, that was scary. That's where you get in the final race. The gloves are off. Taking some risk. Okay, double overtake attempt. Part two. Let's see if we can get it this time. Through the hairpin. Again, not my best run through there. Getting some oversteer on the rear tyres, but let's see, we're gaining on Sainz here. We've got a lot more straight line speed in the McLaren. So this should be a foregone conclusion, hopefully. Outside line one more time, but we're going to just walk around. Can we get Ocon as well on the same straight? Here we go. Not bad, actually. Even with a compromised exit, we get a good exit out of there. Getting the momentum. We're going to go to the outside one more time. There it is. Job done. Finally, we're through. That took a bit longer than I would have liked, but we're now P8 in the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix after 7 laps. Alex Albon up next. We've got a bit of clear track now, so let's use that to try and set some, you know, some good lap times. Okay, Alex Albon pits for Red Bull. We set a new personal best. That final sector was very quick. A few more cars in the pit lane, so we're now up to P6 in this race. Both Ferraris are up the road. Let's go hunt them down. Okay, a few more cars are pitting. I'm on an absolute flyer here. Very good lap from us. Oh! Oh my goodness me, Ricardo! He's out of the race. Oh no! That's so disappointing. For his final race in Formula 1, Ricardo is out of the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. And that is not the way I thought it would end. I really didn't. That is not good. What a shame. Ricardo retires from Formula 1 and from the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. Damn. We did set a personal best and a fastest lap on that last lap though. Bottas is running mediums out front, so Bottas is the man we're looking at. We've got to try and close that gap, so let's go. Let's push on here. Let's do it for Daniel. Mr. Charles Leclerc in the pit lane for Ferrari. So we're going to move up to P2 now.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the softs.
We'll pit lap 12 for the soft tyres. That's going to be perfect for us. Ooh, okay, Bottas pits already. That's interesting. Very early stop from him onto the soft tyre. So maybe he's going to the mediums later on in the race. Either way, we take the race lead here at Abu Dhabi. I've just made an adjustment. I'm going to pit this lap instead. I'm going to go for mediums and go to lap 22 because the medium tyre is a much better race tyre around here. I just remembered what I've done last year strategy-wise, and I've done 2 medium tyre stints. The medium is just so more consistent. You know, it lasts a lot longer. You can set better lap times for longer. The soft tyres go off very quick around here. So I'm going to tweak my strategy. This is what I've done last year and it worked really well for us. We'll pit lap 22 for soft tyres and just do 6 laps on the softs. And that's what worked best. So here we go.
Release.
2.7, not the best stop, but hopefully we'll rejoin behind Verstappen here.
Only one stop to go. One stop left in this strategy.
Or behind Vettel maybe instead. There goes Sebastian, just ahead of us. So we rejoin P7. I'll take that. That's okay. Fresh mediums though. We should be still very quick. We've got the leaders just up the road. You can see them onto the back straight right now. So we are well in the mix of the race win here. This is looking good. And now we've got a good tyre. So we should have a very lasting advantage here on this, which is great. So we should have a much more consistent stint. And then those soft tyres at the end will be like the finishing blow. And that's going to really hurt everyone because everyone should be on mediums at the end of the race. So those soft tyres will be devastating. I think we're going to get Vettel here, actually. Don't think I wasn't planning for it, but we're going to get him. Here we go. Again, just the grip on these tyres. Look at this. Ferrari, of course, not as quick as it once was, so we breeze past. Vettel tries to re-challenge on the braking. Fair play, but we're going to just sweep around the outside. And there we go. Job done. P6. I'm so much quicker than Verstappen now. These medium tyres have got so much more pace. I'm absolutely flying. I'm also on for a personal best and to improve on my previous fastest lap. I've dropped a bit of time in this final sector, of course, because I'm following Max, where we should still improve by 3/10. And there we go, new fastest lap. Happy days. Let's try and get past then, the Super Max it, and move up into the top 5 of the race. And then we've got to try and claw that gap to the cars ahead. You can see Bottas a few laps ago, he was 10 seconds up the road. He's just 5 to 6 seconds now, so we're really flying here, and those leaders are stuck behind a couple of other cars on mediums, so this has worked out perfectly for us. There it is, switchback of dreams once again through the hairpin, hitting that line perfectly, and now we just wait for the DRS. This should be a straightforward move. We know the Honda engine is not too bad, but I've got the momentum a lot earlier this time, and Verstappen has no DRS, and there we go, we're through just like that. Top 5, let's keep going. We can definitely win this race, without a doubt. Another fastest lap on the way as we fly through the final sector, this time without any traffic. We improve by nearly 8/10 to a low 32. We've already dropped Verstappen by 2 seconds. Let's keep going. This pace is absolutely perfect. Worth noting, I thought the Renault was someone who had to pit again, but they don't. It's actually Pierre Gasly. I believe he's a net race leader, as Lewis Hamilton plunges into the pit lane for Mercedes. He's going to mediums now, so we're going to have a tyre advantage at the end of the race when we've gone to the softs. But Pierre Gasly leading here at Abu Dhabi, what a performance from him. He's had a great season, a lot of, you know, podiums or pretty close to podiums this season. And he's really driven an incredible season, just like in real life. And he leads here this race, but look at this now. We're putting some pressure on these boys. Leclerc and Bottas here, who are running line astern. It's going to be tricky to get by, but we might actually be able to get them both here if we time this right. Here we go then. Works Mercedes versus customer car. We're both closing in on Leclerc at the same time though. Let's see what happens. I'm going to just sit back a minute. Just watch them duke it out as we go through the chicane. I'm going to open up the line. Bottas looking like he's got the edge on Leclerc there. Now we're going to come through. I'm going to switch, try and find a bit of space. Okay, we're going to go to the outside. Here we go then. Using the straight line speed to blast ahead. Leclerc's going to try and dive back up the inside, but we go around the outside. And there it is, double overtake. As sweet as you like. Exactly what the doctor ordered. And we're now P2. Gasly up the road. I'm expecting Gasly to probably stay a bit longer, but Leclerc and Bottas will probably pit this lap. So let's see if that's the case. I'm going to just stay on board here for a bit longer to see if they do. I've not really seen Gasly much this race. I didn't realize he was in the mix for the race lead. So I'm assuming he's going to pit for soft tires later. But I could be wrong, and I am wrong. And there we go. Gasly actually pits now. So he's going to go for the mediums again. And Leclerc and Bottas will follow in, I believe. Yes, they do. So there we go. We take the race lead once again. And we are out front by ourselves. Crucial phase now. These laps have got to be good to keep ourselves in the mix. I can't lie. We might be able to overcut here and rejoin in the race lead. The pace has been very good. And the cars behind did respond a little bit at first with the fresh tyres. But they've kind of lost that edge now. So I've been very consistent within 1 or 2 tenths of my personal best every lap. So this is why I wanted the medium tyres, because they're just a lot more consistent around here and they're the far better race tyre. And now these soft tyres are purely just for a couple of quick laps and get any last overtakes done that I need to get done. So here we go then. We need a good stop from the boys. Let's see what it is.
Exit now.
Not the best, 2.6, but we're looking good here. Here comes Gasly.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Pierre will get ahead of us. What about Lewis? It's going to be neck and neck with Hamilton here in the Mercedes. But I think we've just got him. Yes, we have. And we're ahead of Lewis Hamilton. So we rejoin in P2.
There's 5 laps of fuel remaining.
I feel bad to do this to Pierre Gasly, who's driven a magnificent race. But we are going to have to take away a potential race win from him. Because I want that P1. Because that means we get the record of 14 race wins in a season. To cap off probably one of the most dominant seasons in F1 history. Here we go then, let's close in on Pierre. I might be able to actually nab some DRS possibly here. If I can close it enough through here and get the traction down through the next right-hander. Yep, there we go, we've just nicked it and we've also just dropped Hamilton out of DRS range, so the attack begins already. Next lap will be the one. Here we go, this is going to be the historic overtake right here. Just going to set Pierre up nicely through the hairpin and wait for the opportunity. Now we get the power down out of there. Easy does it. We know the Renault isn't the strongest engine. And look at this. The straight line speed just starts to kick in. Pierre's trying to hang on, but it's not going to be enough as we move up ahead into the race lead. Bit hot on the brakes there, but we'll get it slowed down just about. Pierre will try to re-challenge, but no way through. And just like that, we're now into the race lead from the back of the grid. 4 laps to go, and we're 4 laps away from a historic 14th race win of the season. It's going to be a new fastest lap as well, but we're going to try and go even quicker this time around. So this now is going to be my push lap. And here it comes to cap off the season. An absolute cruncher of a fastest lap, a 130.4. And with that is going to be it. We can now cruise to the finish. We're nearly 5 seconds clear of Pierre Gasly. Let's just bring this one home. Here we go then, for the final time through the hotel section. What a year, guys. A 3-year process comes to an end. As we win the Drivers' Championship, the Constructors' Championship. 1-2 for the drivers as Ricciardo gets second and retires from Formula 1. But through the final corner, Season 3 is over and we're a 14-time race winner in a season and a brand new record has been set. Yes! What a car. What a car. Insane. What a season. I'm so, so happy. Damn.
It's been
been a roller coaster season then, but they can go into the winter with their heads held high after an emphatic victory here today. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, when you overtake that many people, I'd certainly hope you'd win the race. Their car was really effective in the slipstream here today, and the team would be pleased that they didn't cook the engine, given how long they were spending in the hot air behind other cars. They had a lot of confidence to push their tyres hard as well, especially going into the corners, which allowed for some late braking and some exciting passes.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.
Well, guys, there we go. The race is done. We pick up the race win and the fastest lap from the back of the grid. We dominate. Season over, and we fully deserve it. 14 races won the season. A brand new all-time record surpassing Michael Schumacher, my hero. And what a year, guys. I don't think we'll ever drive a car like this ever again. If I could, you know, if the car was alive right now, you know, I'd pet it a little bit, you know, and stroke it and just say thank you very much, because this car has been insane. But we move on. Season 4 is upon us, guys. We look at the final results, though. We win ahead of Gasly, who gets a great podium in the final race ahead of Hamilton. Bottas misses out on the podium along with Leclerc, Verstappen, Vettel, Albon, Sainz and Ocon. And then missing out the points, we have Perez, Norris, Magnussen, Kvyat, Stroll, De Vries, Aitken, Latifi, Russell, Giovinazzi and Grosjean one lap down. And Ricciardo, in his F1 swan song, his final F1 race, unfortunately retires. We then move into the standings for the final time. We end the season 131 points clear of the nearest rival, which was our teammate, Daniel Ricciardo. Hamilton, at best, was third, so he loses his crown as a seven-time world champion. And then finally, the constructor standings, 236 points clear. And that is domination, guys. That is it. Season 3 is done, guys. If you enjoyed the video, then smash the like button. Let's see if we're trying to hit 1,000 likes for the finale. We'll do another episode soon regarding all the admin and preparation for Season 4. So get subscribed for that, guys. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for the support throughout the entire season. It's been a great, great year, especially the second half of the season. We've broken all records and dominated more than ever. But Season 4 is going to be interesting. A new teammate, a new engine, regulation change. It's all an unknown. So guys, tune in to the next episode for the Season 4 preview. And finally, guys, check out the two videos on your screen if you haven't seen them already, guys. But that is it. Thank you, guys, for your support. And I'll see you all very soon for Season 4. But until then, take care. And it's goodbye from me.